Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you've clicked to watch this video, you're probably in panic mode right now because your address is refusing to attach to Tangle and you think you've lost your IOTA coins. But just relax, because you haven't. I'm going to show you how you can work around that. First of all, if you log onto your IOTA wallet and you see a page like this, check that you have internet connection. But most times it's not your internet connection. You just have to keep trying until it works. Yes, I know it sucks, but at the moment, IOTA haven't really done anything about this. Now let's move on to the next issue. So this is the error message you get, invalid response when you try to attach to Tangle. Now, if you've sent IOTA from your Binance, it will automatically attach when the transaction has been processed. But then this can take some time, so I would just say relax, don't panic. If you've sent from Bitfinex, then you have to manually attach it to Tangle. Attaching to Tangle, if you're successful the first time, can take a few minutes, so I would say just relax. And if you get this invalid response, then you can either wait for some time. It just means that the node your wallet is communicating with did not return the expected response to your API call. So either you keep trying and it would go through at some point when it connects to the node. Most times it's caused by a network overload, especially the Bitfinex node. The Bitfinex node is what I think most people use and is always overcrowded. And if you're not willing to wait, you can just change your node. And I'm going to show you how to change your node now. Let's close that. Let's come into my wallet. So if you want to change your node, all you have to do is go to Tools and Edit Node Configuration. So you click on this bar and there's loads of different nodes you can try and see if any other one works. Or you can go to Custom Node and put your node in there. So there's websites like this, iotasalad.org, where you can come and copy a good node. It says good node, good node, good node. And then, yeah, good node. And there's another one called IOTA Dance where there's good nodes as well that you can copy. So let's come here and copy this to clipboard. Copied. And come here to custom host and just put this one in and then click and save. You can change this as well to CC curl implementation to see if that works for you. But right now, I'm not going to customize my node because apparently Bitfinex is working for me right now. So after you've done all of that and you've changed your node, at some point your transaction should go through. But then if it comes up as pending, then you can check the IOTA live transactions by copying your receive address and pasting it. So I'll copy this address and then paste it in the live transactions website. There's one called IOTA Search and there's another one called thetangle.org. So what you want to do is paste your address in here to see what's going on with your transaction. So that's my transaction that was confirmed. So that's it, it says confirmed. If you go to another web, this website gives you more information about your transaction. So this one gives more information. So this one says this has been confirmed and this was reattached, but it's not going to be confirmed because it's the same address. So note that you cannot use the same address for two different transactions. So make sure you're not trying to use the same address. If not, one of them will be pending forever. A new address will be generated every time you want to do a new transaction. So if your transaction has been attached, but then it's still pending, what you can do is go back to your IOTA wallet and try to reattach the transaction. So say for example, you want to reattach this transaction because it shows pending, all you have to do is click on bundle. That's if it's not a duplicated transaction like what you can see here. Oh, see, the wallet is gone again. This will happen a lot of times when you're trying to use your wallet, guys. Your balance will go to zero. But don't worry about it because it just means there's something wrong with the connection to the node. It will come back in a few minutes and you'll see your balance. So I'll wait for this to come back, then I'll continue showing you guys what I was about to show you before. So now my wallet is back up and running. That took a good 10 minutes for my wallet to come back. So I was going to show you guys how to reattach your transaction bundle to Tangle. So what you want to do is click on show bundle. That's going to take another 5 to 10 minutes again. God. So to reattach your pending transaction, when you scroll down to the bottom here, you would see rebroadcast. It would say rebroadcast here. Mine is not here because this is not a valid transaction and it's not a proper pending one because it's the same transaction I did here, but then I did it twice. That's why it's not going to let me rebroadcast it. But it'll be something that will come up in red here for you guys to reattach your pending transaction to Tangle. One last thing, just as you guys could see how my wallet has been going from now, my balance is back. Before it was zero, it went out, it came back. So that's going to be happening all the time, depending on how good the node you connected to is. So don't panic. When you're trying to log in may not be very straightforward. Sometimes you have to try it five times, sometimes once, sometimes you have to try it five times. That's pretty much what the IOTA wallet is. This GUI wallet is not perfect, so we have to, just make do with it the way it is. I hope I've been of little help. Please like this video and share with anyone that may have this problem with the IOTA wallet. And thank you very much for watching. I'll see you on my next video.